Hi everybody, it's Matt from Style Factory, the go-to site for e-commerce reviews and advice. In this Shopify tutorial for beginners, I'm going to walk you through the process of building a Shopify store. I'm going to do this in a friendly, jargon-free way and help you get your store live quickly and easily. A quick tip before I begin, so that you can return to this tutorial easily if you need to, I suggest bookmarking this page in your web browser. And, so that you can learn at your own pace, if you check the video description, you'll find timestamps for all the key steps outlined in this video. You can also use the playback speed controls in the video settings to watch this tutorial at a speed that works for you. Okay, let's start building your store. The first step involves getting prepared. 1. Make sure you have everything you need for your store to hand. Before building your Shopify store, it's a good idea to have everything you need for it to hand. This will speed up the process and give you a more professional result. The key things you'll usually need are a business idea, a strong business name, a logo, products, photos of your products, and content for your store's pages. 2. Start a free Shopify trial. The next thing you'll need to do is start a Shopify trial. The best way to do this is to use Shopify's special 3-month trial because it gives you a lot more time to build your sites. I've put a link to this in the video description. Setting this up involves answering a few onboarding questions, but the process is pretty quick and within a few minutes you'll have access to your Shopify account dashboard. 3. Add products to your Shopify store. Once you've signed up for your free Shopify trial, you might be tempted to start picking themes and trying out design ideas. However, it's usually better to add your products first, because they will have a big impact on the look and feel of your store. It's best to avoid spending a long time on choosing a theme, only to find that it doesn't really work that well with your products. So at this point, I'd suggest just sticking with the default theme and picking your final theme later. To add your products, just go to Products, Add Product in your Shopify dashboard. Then, it's a case of adding in the key information about your product, like product title, description, and pricing information. This is all pretty straightforward. We have a Style Factory blog post about starting a Shopify store available, which goes through each product attribute in more depth. You'll find a link to this in the description for this video. 4. Create product collections for your store. Once you've added your products to your store, you can organize them into collections. Collections are groups of similar types of products. For example, if you ran an online greetings card store, you might create a birthday card collection, a Christmas card collection, and so on. Organizing your products into collections lets you display key products on your home page, create links in your site navigation to particular sets of products, and run discounts on selected items. To create a collection, just go to Products, Collections in your Shopify store and click the Create Collection button. What you have to pay particular attention to here is your collection type. Shopify lets you create a manual collection or a smart one. If you choose the manual option, you will then be given the opportunity to search for products and add them to a collection one by one. If you choose the smart option, you will be asked to set up some simple rules that populate your collection automatically based on things like product title or tag. 5. Create your store pages. The next thing you need to do is create your store's pages. Examples of the kind of pages you'll usually need to create include an About Us page, FAQ, a refund policy page, a contact page, and blog posts. With the exception of blog posts, all these can be created in the same way. You simply go to Online Store, Pages, and click Add Page. To create blog posts, you go to Content, Blog Posts, and click Create Blog Post. 6. Create your main menu. Once you've got your products and pages in place, it's time to create your store's main menu. To add a main menu to a Shopify store, go to Content, Menus. Click the Main Menu option and add your pages and collections to your main menu using the Add Menu Item option provided. If you need to move items around, just click on the grid to the left of the page name and drag the page to where you'd like it to go. When you're done, just click the Save button. If you like, you can use this section to create other types of menus too, like a footer menu or sidebar menus. 7. Choose a theme. At this point, you've got your products, collections, pages, and main menu all sorted, so it's finally time to pick your Shopify theme. To do this, go to Online Store, Themes, Import Theme, and click the Visit Theme Store button. This will take you to Shopify's theme library, where you can pick a paid or free theme that meets your requirements. 8. Build your home page. Once you've settled on your Shopify theme, it's time to customize one of your store's most important pages, the home page. To do this, go to Online Store, Themes, and click the Customize button. This will take you to a drag-and-drop editor for your home page. The layout and the options available to you here will vary by theme, but all Shopify themes typically let you add sections like hero images, slideshows, featured collections, and contact forms. 9. Apply your brand. Now it's time to customize your store so that it makes use of your own logo, brand colors, and typefaces. To do this, go to Online Store, Themes, Customize. To add a logo, you'll then need to click the Header option, then click on Theme Settings and press the Select button in the Logo section to upload your logo file. To customize colors and typefaces, click the cog icon on the left and make any necessary changes using the colors and typography settings provided. 10. Set up your shipping rates. With your products, content, and design all in place, it's time to think about how you're going to ship your products to your customers. To access your shipping settings, you need to go to Settings, Shipping and Delivery in your Shopify dashboard. There, you'll be able to set up various different types of shipping rates, including flat shipping rates, rates based on price or weight, calculated shipping rates, free shipping rates, and local pickup. I've put a link to some more detailed advice on how to set up shipping rules with Shopify in the video description. 11. Set up your tax rates. Many merchants will need to charge sales tax or value-added tax on purchases of their products. Rules vary considerably by country, so it can be worth asking a tax professional how you should configure these for your store. The tax settings in Shopify can be located in the Shopify dashboard by going to Settings, Taxes and Duties. I've put a link to a help resource on Shopify tax settings in the video description. 12. Choose a payment gateway for your store. In order to accept payment for your products, you need to choose a payment gateway. This is basically the software that processes credit card purchases made from your store. Shopify works with over 100 payment gateways and has its own built-in one too, Shopify Payments. For many merchants, Shopify Payments will be the quickest payment processor to get started with, and it's the only one you can use without incurring transaction fees. You should note that Shopify Payments is only available in certain countries, however. To enable a payment gateway, just go to Settings, Payments in your Shopify dashboard, and follow the instructions provided. 13. Connect your domain. Although Shopify gives you access to a free myshopify.com URL that you can technically launch your site on, it's best to use a custom domain name for your store. This will generate more trust in your website and brand amongst potential customers. You can purchase one from a domain name provider, for example Namecheap, Gandy, or Network Solutions. Alternatively, you can buy one direct from Shopify or transfer one you've already bought elsewhere into the platform. To buy a domain or connect an existing one in Shopify, just go to Settings, Domains in your dashboard. Just pick the relevant option and follow the instructions provided. 14. Prepare your store for launch. Once your domain is connected, you could technically just put it live immediately, but it's much better to check that all aspects of your store are working as expected first, and that's where a Shopify launch checklist comes in. Tasks on a launch checklist include ensuring that payments are definitely being accepted, tax rates and shipping options are working correctly, all your site copy is correct, and that there are no broken links on your site. For a full list of the checks we suggest making before launching a Shopify store, please see the link provided in the description for this video. 15. Publish your Shopify store. When you're done with your pre-launch checks, you can publish your store. By default, each new Shopify store is password protected, and you need to remove this password in order to make your site publicly visible. Just go to Online Store, Preferences, and scroll down to the Password Protection section to do this. And that's it. Your Shopify store is live. I hope you've enjoyed this Shopify tutorial, but if you'd like to access an even more detailed guide to setting up a Shopify store, you'll find a link to one in the description for this video. To ensure you don't miss any of our tips on how to make the most of your Shopify store going forward, make sure you like this video, click the subscribe button, and hit the notifications bell. And finally, if you have any questions about starting a Shopify store, do leave them in the comments. We read them all, and we'll do our best to help.